What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is Flyer 444. Here is Pyke building zero damage, going absolutely insane. Now, I built no damage items this game. I only built support items and tank. That being said, I'm just gonna let the gameplay speak for itself. There is a little bit of an embarrassing incident level 2-ish, I think, so keep an eye on that. Anyway, hope you enjoy the video. Have a good time. We're gonna go ahead and start. We're playing up against a Zyrakon, so this is actually a matchup that you might see in game. We're rocking the pink chroma skin of the Sand Pyke. Sand Pyke, that doesn't sound right. But anyway, we are going to be starting our Q first, just in case. I don't think that Pyke's level 1 in lane is actually good, and this running animation is hilarious. Okay, that's a little bit more edgy. I like that. Everyone fits. Nice. So, what we're gonna have here is we're probably gonna have like a nasty bot lane. And by that I mean is that I'm effectively countered, so nothing's gonna happen. not unless I am really, really insane, this Pyke. That being said, I do have this, so that does mean that I am going to be nice and toasty. The cool thing about this is that if I... So I'm going to be mainly going on for Zaya. As in, Rakan will just destroy me. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off by taking one minion. I'm gonna save this one for the cannon next wave. There should be a cannon next wave. It doesn't really matter. You know what? I kind of fucked up already. Off rip. The kind of tricky thing about Pyke level 1 or his Q is that cool. So, but yeah, that's the right way to play Pyke, right there. Oh my god. But anyway, you see the relatively right way to play Pyke. I think, as in, you E engage onto them and then you flip them over. So that's actually like not bad. I don't think it's not terrible. Like it's obviously not great, but it's not the end of the world. They've already shown themselves to be susceptible to like that combo is just disgusting. So that's kind of gonna be really interesting. I thought that she was in range for that. My bad. So go ahead and kind of take care of that. I actually should have just taken the kills right there. Like I actually stopped autoing Rakan. So that way I could, I thought that the Caitlyn was gonna get the kill. Obviously that didn't happen. But I think... Let's see, two kills. Not first blood, though. Also, this guy's fucking 3-0. I like that. I really appreciate that. Okay. So the engage here is, or the problem with the engage here is that Rakan kind of countered me. So that's easy. Like, that's super easy. Like, they got greedy, and so we punished them. Cool. So I'll just be taking that. So that's easy. That's super easy. Like, look at that. Like, Pyke is so OP, like, what the hell? People telling me that this guy's not insane? Come on. Also, like, the guy is like, as long as you're playing him smart, I think that you're fine with him. Like, you have to play him smart. Like, these guys, they're ahead. Like, this guy is 2-1. But they're not playing smart. They're not playing correctly. They're not, you know, they're basically saying, you know what, we're ahead and therefore we can do whatever we want. You can't do that. So the main thing is to just be smart about how you play. So I'm building HP because I want that extra little bonus damage. I've got 95 at level 5. So that's not going to be too bad. So 200 HP execute. Not bad either. Like, really not bad. I'll go ahead and ping that so that way I'll let my person know when they are about to do. What I want Rakan to do is I want Rakan to use his. I want him to use his either E or his W. Go ahead and now come back in. Easy. Look at that. That's how you play Pyke support. This is how you actually play Pyke. You're not supposed to go in constantly. You're supposed to pick your fights. You're supposed to kind of choose really, really wisely how you want to play. For instance, should we be winning right now? Absolutely not. But am I gonna gank mid? Absolutely. Easy. Sure you don't want a dragon? Alright. Well, I'm gonna leave now. Because I need some gold. I got some gold, and I'm looking thirsty. So, they're a majority, like, AP team. Wait. No, they're just underfed. So I can actually build full damage, but what I really want to show y'all is the, is this nifty build that I got going on for support Pyke. I actually have built zero anything. Like, I don't have any. Wow, and that is her flash. So I'm gonna go ahead and go over here, regen a little bit, you know. Just
Like, it's, they're not respecting the Pyke at all. And it's showing. Like, it's really disappointing the way that these guys are going about their business. So, like, I am just going absolutely crazy. Like, kind of ridiculous at the moment. 412 has Pyke support. Pyke support. No damage build. None. I'm gonna go ahead and just build those boots of resist. If I'd taken overgrowth, I'd be even stronger. Like, come on, guys. Not only are these people bad, but I appear to be, like, somewhat decent at this game, so if I can do this, then anyone can. Like, literally, it's not even like this is particularly challenging or hard, it's just that these people are making mistakes that I am capitalizing on. So, yeah, you should probably leave, lady. You don't do very much damage to me. Regen a little bit, thank you. Now I'm back. And I will just stop this fine lady from taking a tower. That's literally all I really want to do. I don't want to get hit by feathers. She's welcome to take minion aggro if she wishes. Okay. She's, you know, she's getting whittled down by minions. She's not really getting that much farm. I'm fine with that. Like, if y'all want to do that. Oh, give me that. Come on. So, like, I'm not building any damage. This is zero damage type. Like, it's ridiculous, these people. Like, they're not respecting me at all. So now I'm 4-1-4. So now I'm going to start building a little bit, still not going to build any AD, no AD. That's going to be the gimmick this game. So I've got 20% CDR, I'm not even level 10 yet. And our Zed's Spanish. So the reason I build this is because this gives me an extra 10 AD. So now we're up to 40 extra AD, 132 AD in total.
The surface won't be the top much longer.
This is after giving up a double kill bot lane. Like, this is not like I'm playing well either. Like, this is coming back from a disadvantage. If I had taken overgrowth, I would be around, let's say, 10 AD stronger at this point. I'm gonna go ahead and push this lane out and then join my comrade later. Actually, do I want to? I'll just go until someone comes and then I'll just, you know, W away. I just kind of want to take some farm right now, so that way I can go about my business later. Ooh, that's not good. No AD. None. I'm not building any this game. Haven't built a single thing. 157 attack. So now we get to see this really interesting mechanic where you Righteous Glory and then immediately go into your W. Oof. You ain't gonna like that. I'll actually show it off right now. Go. So that's how that's done. Righteous Glory, 87 seconds. What you're gonna start seeing, actually, you know what, I'm gonna robot. So I really do want to go bot this time, because that is a lot of fun that I do not want to be wasted. Also, I want to kind of protect this tower, but mostly I just want to farm. Mmm, yum. Delicioso. So that was actually pretty lucky in that mid lane fight. Got a lot of gold. From that. Rampage. Shut down. An ally has been slain. I'm gonna have to go mid. Wins in the same waters as me. Cool. I've got my Righteous Glory, so we're gonna actually see how this works in a fight. So now I just go back bot. Don't wanna really bother with that right now. Not right now. But as you can see, like, the guy is just busted. Still building 0, 0, 0 ADs. You can kind of tell because I'm not doing that much damage. At the same time, I'm doing enough. Like, this guy feels really good right now. So now I'm gonna just... go back. It's cool. So we're gonna build our first CDR that's excess over the limit. So we're gonna build that, and we're gonna build this. So So now we should be around. Yeah, we got about. So 10%, 10%, 10%. So that's 30%. So I have an extra 12 AD by the end of this. Oof. 173, no damage yet. I wonder if I can solo the dragon at the moment. Gonna just take this. That's a lot of gold. So now we've got our extra 12 AD. So now we're at around 200. So we're gonna go ahead and get one of these. And you know what? To be honest, let's build an adaptable. Just one. And we'll go ahead and run bot lane. How long is this? 12 seconds? Yeah. I'll be fine. Five. Four. Two. Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Like, this is just not the oh. Disappear. Easy.
This is how you play Pyke support. You don't need to worry about any of, you know, building any damage. You don't need to build Duskblade. You don't need to build anything. All you need to do. You know what, actually. How much is this? 450 health. So that's like what? 30 some odd?
Magic.
Or 80?
Versus. I don't really have any use for the passive. Legendary. I'll go ahead and take this one.
Rampage. So now that 240. Still haven't got a single idea. Yet. Still haven't got a single AD item. This guy only has. This guy literally has less AD than I do. I don't know. Execute. I don't know. 600. I actually clicked the wrong way over there. That's my bad. One 11. And not a bad score to boot. So I'm gonna go ahead and build that. Now we're up to 240. Like, I don't know what the counterplay is. So it's like, what are you gonna do? Nothing. Can't do anything. Actually, you know what? That doesn't give me any AD, so I'll go ahead and build this. Which gives me 225 divided by 14. So that gives me like 18-ish AD. I have built no damage in this game. None. I've built precisely zero. This combo is insane. The Righteous Glory into W. That's gonna be, I think, meta on him as support. Like, at this point, their health bars are literally half executed.
actually okay.
GG. That's how you play Pyke support. Let's look at the damage chart. Note, remember, no damage dealt.
You're basically done.
This combo, like, the important thing to realize is that you have to 5W, so that way they don't see it coming, and also W will immediately cancel if you use this on it. So that's going to be an important thing to know. Also, a common misconception that I have seen Pyke players do is they think that this puts you in an iframe. This does not. Like, you can die cast animation. And it is a relatively low, long animation. So, not that. So, remember, don't W first, 5W. I did it, I think, a couple times in game on accident. And this is not an iframe. So this is like this is pretty decent. Like these numbers are pretty good. If you really want, you can go ahead and get rid of that and just buy magic resist boots, and in which case you're even better.
What's worth more? A pound of flesh or a gallon of blood?
So let's go ahead and just sell everything, and I'll show you, except for the support item, the boots, and the righteous glory. So you're working around 163 AD, and you're at 30% CDR, and you're like, man, what do I get? Get a dust blade for the AD if you really want to get a maw, and then build whatever damage they got like higher. Or you can cheat and go Sterix. Like that, then you're at a very comfortable 359. Obviously, you're going to be doing a hell of a lot more damage with these two items. Actually, don't build Sterix. I'm mistaken. I think that the correct answer is Black Cleaver. Yeah, if you build Black Cleaver, you end up with actually, was that
what's worth more? A pound of flesh or a gallon of blood?
Yeah, you end up with a little bit more. You end up with around 20 AD more if Black Cleaver, because of the CDR. So this is like really powerful, 36. And let's say that the game drags out to like 30 minutes. So you've got 50 AD.
There's no way I'm good for
just
business.
Randomly 50 extra AD, and you're at 387. And this is at 20 minutes. I was 11-1-11 last game. Now, granted, they were playing it really, really badly. Here's another combo that you can do. The main thing that I see Pyke players doing is that they're using their Q as the initiation. If you use the Q as the initiation, you're going to dash here, obviously. But the problem with the Q, it's not a stun. You don't stun anything with a Q. Let me show you what I mean. Let me spawn enemy dummy. Wait, is this like... Oh, that just disappears. Spawn target dummy. Okay.
Folk have a way with persuasion.
Let's say that this is like an actual champion. You see how very specific that is? Let me show you again. At full range. And it's even worse because, like right here, that's a very long animation. This is me like spamming Q. Let me go move back. This is like me spamming Q or E as soon as the guy. This is me spamming it as soon as the guy comes out. So what you want to do is you want to like, and then when they're trying to run away from you, when they're trying to run away from you, that's when you flip them forwards, because when you do that, when you've got them stunned like this, so hold on, they're gonna immediately start running this way or this way or this way, right? They're gonna immediately try to get away from you.
And that gives you an excellent opportunity. And your ADC is already attacking them, or your teammates attack them, or whatever. When you do this, when they're trying to run away, you're flinging them into your ADC, into your minion wave. And then you just ignite them and ult them. Also, like, this stuff is on a very low cooldown. So, let me show you a proper combo. I'll actually walk backwards. So. So, I just did 1400 damage with about that. And this isn't even execute, this doesn't count ignite or anything. So let me go ahead and show you that again. $1,500 damage. And this, I mean, this is me like leaving auto attacks in and whatnot when I get over here. But his kit, especially in lane, is insane. Let me show you something that you can do. Teleport to location. So you're over here, right? Let's go ahead and spawn enemy dummy. You're over here. Let's say that you're minion. You've got like an ADC over here, right? So you're like this. There's a minion wave around here. Duck into this bush. Just do it. They're gonna probably move around here, so I'll go ahead and do this, and then just throw them back in the air. And your ADC should know like what's going on at the moment. Like this is like nothing. Like this is within, I'd say, the far reaches of auto attack range. So I mean, like let's say that you're even in here. Even further. But you, if you're in the middle of a minion wave, I mean, obviously that thing has the less likelihood of a hit, but why are you engaging in the middle of a minion wave? Also, the cool thing about this is that when you do your E combo, like this, all the minions beside you that would normally walk into this skill shot are now stunned, or they're just standing still autoing you. If you're taking targets, you can actually auto once or twice before you do anything, and you can just clear the minions. I don't know if it happened the last game that I played him, but I mean there was this one, I think there was like one moment where I did this auto and then that. So you're gonna want to engage with me. Don't, as a Pyke player, I see a lot of this. They're like, oh man, I need to charge this up, manage to hit the guy, then I dash forwards, and they expect the person to stay still. It's ridiculous. No, you do this, and by the time that they're out of the stun, like if you immediately press your Q, go here, easy. Well, the hardest part is this, but if you build this item, you're good. Because they're slowed, they can't get out of your stun, unless they flash, in which case you've already won because, you know, you're tight. Garbage. You're supposed to. Okay, so. Let's see, can I? I can't. I mean, you just, like, have one hell of a time. Alright. So that's me playing Pyke. I hope you enjoyed this no damage build. But yeah, thank you. Have a good one.